Today's episode is brought to you by Audible. Squat wisely with a brand new audiobook. Visit http://www.audibletrial.com/squat and get a free audiobook with your 30-day trial membership.
She is a passionate philosophy professor,
fitness professional,
and motivational speaker. She helps strengthen the body, but she also helps strengthen the mind.
The mind.
For well over a decade, she has led philosophy courses within the University System of Georgia.
She leads group fitness classes in Atlanta,
as well as leading one-on-one personal training sessions. Let's all squat wisely with Kristen Hester.
I am excited because today's episode is all about the Atlanta Vegan Festival. It took place on October the 8th in Atlanta, Georgia at Atlanta Metropolitan College. And it was an awesome time. It was a very rainy day in Georgia. I may sound a little bit under the weather because I caught a cold. I was in and out of the rain a little bit. But I still feel great overall. A lot of people came out. The rain did not deter the crowd. It was just a great time. A little bit later on in the show, you're going to hear from some of the people who were in attendance. Some of the things that I took away the most from the whole experience was just seeing all of these Black-owned businesses all come together for a common goal, a common cause, to share health, to share wealth, really. When you think about it, they say your health is your wealth. And it was so many businesses with that frame of mind in mind in the building on October the 8th. I met some great people. I discovered some new products, some products I already knew about. I discovered some new restaurants, some I already knew about, and some I had no idea was in the Atlanta area. So it's just a really, really great time. I do know that some people did travel to actually attend the event. Some of the people who had tables, I had a table at the event, and there was a few people who I know traveled just to show off their business and some of the things and products that they have to complement a vegan journey. So guys, it was just an awesome time. I don't want to overly talk too much because, like I said, you probably can hear it in my voice, but I caught a cold and I'm under the weather. But please just stay tuned and listen to some of these cool highlights and listen to the people talk about their own vegan journey after we get back from the break.
Jordis A1 Solutions has a fitness solution just for you. For your personal training needs, we serve clients who reside in Atlanta, Georgia, and nearby cities. We also help clients to achieve their goals online as well. To inquire, visit jordis.com. Jordis is J-O-R-T-I-S.
Yo, the Atlanta Vegan Festival was all that in a bag of kale chips. Kick back to hear some of the attendees share their vegan journey.
So you're at the Atlanta Vegan Festival.
Yes, ma'am.
And do you want to tell us your first name?
Yes, my name is Catherine.
Catherine, so tell us, why are you vegan? How did you become a vegan?
So I was actually vegetarian for 8 years prior, and I had to just be honest with myself and say, you know what, I'm gaining weight. I'm starting to get a little bit slower. I need to be honest to see that this isn't the way that I should live. So I started going vegan, and 4 years later, that's where I am.
Awesome. Well, you look amazing.
Thank you, ma'am.
Well, thank you for stopping by and talking to Squat Wisely.
Thank you, ma'am. Appreciate it.
All right. So tell us, why are you a vegan now?
Okay, this was basically just a natural process that happened to me over time. I just noticed that the food and everything I was consuming, I was just having problems. Not major problems, but like over time I seen like bumps and stuff on my skin for no reason and stuff like that. And my pot had a certain smell to it. And I noticed once I started converting, all that stuff just disappeared. So it's obvious that the way that I was eating or the things I was consuming was not right for my body. So vegan is just common sense, just the best way to go. Because it's the natural things that you put in your body. It's just as simple as that.
Exactly. Yeah,
that's what got me there.
Tell us your first name.
My name is Josh.
Josh, you got any business? What you doing in Atlanta?
I work in IT right now. So,
okay, nice.
Yep. I'm looking forward in the future to be one of these guys who got a lot of knowledge about the foods and everything, so I can one day do what you guys doing and teach and give back in a good way to humanity.
Yeah. Very nice. Well, yeah. Thank you for stopping by our table.
All right, no problem.
All right, what's your name?
My name's Miranda.
Miranda, so tell us a little bit about your journey into going into a vegan lifestyle.
Right now, I am vegetarian, but I am transitioning to be vegan. I cook vegan food, but the trouble I'm having currently is just completely being off of the dairy products and everything else because I have a citrus allergy. So with me right now, I am getting as much information from everyone just so I can be able to eat properly and just build up to where I can be more comfortable sleeping, eating, and just have a better lifestyle.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for stopping by our table. We appreciate you for sharing with Squat Wisely.
All right. Thank you so much.
All right, guys. We're in Atlanta at the Atlanta Vegan Festival, and today I have...
Mr. Aaron Knox.
Aaron Knox. So, why do you vegan?
Because I want to live. And it's healthy, you know? It's like we know what not to eat. Like, we know what's wrong with us. We know what caused the illnesses, but to get away from it is like the hard part. And last year I stopped eating meat for like 100 days and I relapsed due to social issues, meaning like I would go to restaurants and I would eat with not going to non-vegan restaurants, and when I go to eat and I tell them I don't eat meat and they bringing me out a piece of bread with some lettuce and tomatoes on there, and I just kind of felt like out of place. So after doing that multiple times, I kind of relapsed. But this year I came back maybe 3 months ago. I got rid of everything. Meat, cheese, dairy. And I know it's just so I can be healthy, you know.
Awesome. Well, thank you for stopping by the table. It's so great to meet you today.
You're very welcome. Nice
thank
meeting you.
You
too.
Well, we are closing out the weekend of the Atlanta Vegan Festival. My great friend came in town, Miss LaShonda Anderson. She is what they call a shero, honey, a shero of Black Girls Do Bike in Wichita, Kansas. And she's also like myself, newly embarking upon this vegan / vegetarian journey. And I want to have her give us some wisdom today, and I want her to tell us a little bit about why she even got into biking and why she considered a vegan or vegetarian lifestyle. Welcome, Shonda.
Thank you so much, Chris. It's truly an honor to be here with you this weekend. It's been a very exciting journey, experience being here at the Atlanta Vegan Festival. Just to answer your second question in terms of, you know, how I came into veganism or becoming a vegetarian, it started about 2 months ago, and really it was because of my husband. He was feeling led to change his lifestyle, and we both had been really praying about, you know, how we can really transition our health and do some things differently for ourselves and for our family. And so he did some research and looked at some documentaries, and along with being led of God, he decided to go cold turkey. And when he told me he was going to do it, I really wasn't sure that he was going to do it. But, you know, we were sitting at a wedding and I'm looking at my husband deny meat. And I thought, okay, and I've got chicken on my plate. So I'm like, what am I supposed to do with this? And I barely ate it, but I'm just watching him. And so then the next day we had a dinner at the church. And once more, I see my husband who used to consume meat consistently. I watch him deny meat. And so I thought, okay, he is really serious. And I followed suit. I followed suit, and we've been going strong for the last 2 months, and it's been a great journey. Great journey. So, and what was the next question?
Your love for biking.
Oh, love for biking. Yeah, I love to bike. I love to cycle. I've been doing that, I think, for about 3 years. I think it's been 3 years, and that's been a journey in itself. And it's kind of just started out just wanting to get my kids into biking because I loved to ride when I was a child, and I wanted my children to have that same experience. And so, of course, you know, we had to get bikes. I had to get a bike, you know, in order to ride with them. And that same feeling of excitement and freedom and that love for cycling came back to me instantly. And I just went full force. I left my family, actually, and just went full force, you know. And of course, you know, being a Black female, you know, just blacks in particular on a bike, you really don't see that in Kansas. I know that you see that here on the East Coast and in Atlanta, but you don't really see that a lot in the Midwest. And it was just an experience to meet up with people and even to find African-Americans of like interest in biking. And that just really pushed me. And I found Black Girls Do Bike, and I was really excited about that. And so I've just been going hard. I've done 100 miles. I've recently been licensed as a cycling instructor, certified licensed instructor. And so I'm just pumped, and I'm so excited about life and where this all is taking me, because for the last 3 years, I've made some tremendous changes in my life, and I'm just excited to see what's going to happen next.
You know, speaking of change, you know, change is hard. You know, when it comes to consistently trying to maintain a fitness regimen, that can be hard for people. Changing their diet can be hard for people, even when they know they need to make that change. Leave us with some wisdom, Shonda. Close us out with a wise quote to kind of carry us through those hard times of facing change when we need to do it, but we don't have the consistency to maintain it.
Okay. Well, one of the things that that comes to mind that I really think about, that you hear a lot within the vegan and vegetarian circles and even doctors, they talk about eating to live versus living to eat. And so during those moments when, you know, you feel like you have to have that extra, whatever that extra may be, or you have to have that fried chicken, or, you know, you have to have that donut, you know, let it come to your mind. I'm eating to live. I'm not living to eat. I'm not living to eat for pleasure, but I'm eating to live. And that will help you to really consciously, you know, think about, okay, what am I eating? Why am I doing this? The scripture says that Jesus, he says that I've come to give you life, and that you may have it more abundantly. In other words, he's telling you that you have permission to live life. And so we have to be free enough to give ourselves permission to eat healthy. You know, give yourself permission to eat healthy. And when you consider your family, your surroundings, or your culture and what you're used to, give yourself permission in the midst of the norm to eat healthy. And you will definitely reap the benefits.
Amen. I'm looking for the offering bucket, because Shonda just preached. So we are going to close out the show, because we don't need anything else. Thank you so much, Miss Anderson.
Bless you. Bless you. It's a pleasure.
Go ahead.
I just want to say, before we close out, I just want to say that Chris Hester is the real deal. Let me tell you why she's the real deal. We are sitting in the parking lot outside of the club that she does her fitness, and it's raining, y'all. And we are like not parked close to the building. So that means that we got to walk in the rain. But that just shows how dedicated she is, whether it comes rain, sun, you know, snow, whatever it is, that she is going to do the necessary things that she needs to do to meet her goals. And I'm just thankful to be your friend. I'm so pumped about you. So excited. And that's all I got to say. She's the real deal. We about to walk in this rain, y'all.
Hi.
Are you a vegan?
Yes.
No, you're not. Why are you lying?
I don't know.
That last one was just a silly blooper clip. That was my wonderful sweet helper. Her name is Tyrika. She was making all kinds of money at the vegan festival on Sunday. She was smiling and attracting all kinds of great people to our table. So I am very thankful for her. I am thankful for all of the help and the time that she invested to make our day great. Squat Wisely was well represented. Jordan's A1 Solutions was well represented. And all thanks to the help of sweet Tyrika and, of course, my friend who you just heard from, LaShonda Anderson. Guys, thank you for checking out this episode and hearing from some of the great people who were able to attend this year's Atlanta Vegan Festival, put on by the Black Vegetarian Society of Georgia. You can go over to Facebook and search them on Facebook to like their page and to keep up with their news feed and any updates that they have going on. This is an event that they put on every year, so you may want to check it out for 2018. Even though it is a group that is dedicated to the Black community, it is not limited to the Black community. There are people from all backgrounds, all walks of life in attendance at the Vegan Festival this year. So don't allow the whole Black
Vegetarian Society of Georgia to deter you. If it is something that you are interested in, please come out. Please check it out. You'll learn some cool things. You'll meet some cool people. I've actually since connected with a gentleman. His table was right next to my table. I believe he was probably the busiest